Spending extended time with people fundamentally different from you. What should everyone try at least once in their life? No way, this is insane, my boy is back to watch another story time from Alien Radio. Welcome back. Hope you doing alright bro, bros gotta support each other. You can support us by annihilating that like button. If you do, I'll send you a Lana Rhodes fleshlight. No more games, let's start the stories. Go somewhere with no light pollution, on a clear night, and look at the stars. Exploring different places around your neighborhood on your own, you never realize what you can find until you try. Then bring someone along with you next time and show them. Write a short story that one actually wants to write, especially if it turns out bad. In my experience, experiences in school dissuade people from writing for themselves. Everyone can write something cool and interesting, and failing a lot is part of the process of becoming better. This applies to anything creative, including engineering. It's actually on my bucket list. I would like to be in the grocery store when the person in front of me is struggling to pay for their food. I would like to have enough money to just anonymously pay for their groceries, and not have them know who I am, but to just ease a little pain in this world, allowing them to go home that evening with a full carload of groceries for their family, without having to worry about the money. I've always wanted to do that, but I don't ever have the resources. Solo travel for a few weeks or more. I used to be the type of person that would be very dependent on having other people travel with me. Solo traveling, on the other hand, truly is a liberating feeling. You learn many things about yourself and mature. Having a pet. They make your life so much better. You can talk to somebody for hours without fear of them telling others or judging you. Plus, they will be there for you when your day has been bad. Bonus if the pet is a rescue. There is something about rescue animals that make the bond deeper, even though you have not known them for long. I don't know of anybody that has had pets, but no longer has any pets, unless it's a medical reason. Just spend a few days completely out from the world. Politics? Don't know care, social issues? Don't know care, finances, health, friendships, enemies, items, etc. etc. In today's world, I fear sometimes the amount of information some of us take in might be a little too much in the long run. It's strangely nice to pretend like nothing exists outside of go to work, have a snack, chill, sleep. Important note. Only for a few days, however. Kind of an umbrella, but learn a post-apocalypse skill. That's what I call them in my head. Mine was blacksmithing. I took a blacksmithing course over the summer and learned a staggering amount about what it takes to take raw materials and turn them into useful tools. I have a background in geology, and metallurgy has always interested me, so it made sense. Seriously, find something low or no tech that makes you feel accomplished. Woodworking. Smithing. Animal husbandry. Archery. Soap making. Beekeeping. Hell, grow some corn. Something to remind you where we've been as a species. Learn a musical instrument. Not only is it a useful way to spend your free time, but with a little time and effort, you can easily get good enough to play your favorite songs and create your own tunes as well. I've been playing guitar for 11 years now, and I also picked up the bass about 5 years ago, and it's one of the best feelings in the world when you are able to entertain other people through music. Any instrument will be difficult at first to learn, but by remaining patient, you can easily get to the point where playing an instrument becomes almost a therapeutic experience. And you don't have to bust the bank and purchase the most expensive models just to sound good. A good player can make even a worn-out, broken instrument sound like heaven. Drawing and painting. Don't just give up when you realize it's not perfect on your first try. Artistic skill takes time and practice. It also takes an attentive eye. You can teach yourself these skills. Follow YouTube tutorials and books. Follow Bob Ross while he paints. Be patient with yourself and try your best. Art really is a gift. The ability to communicate ideas to people by drawing them is really helpful in a lot of ways. And it really boosts your confidence knowing you're not total crap at it, lol. It also changes how you perceive the world around you. You start appreciating the little beautiful things more. Give it a go. You'll suck at first. But it'll be worth it. look someone dead in the eyes, and say exactly what you think about them. See how it turns out. My wife and I were visiting a friend. He's a great guy, but he had this long, bad comb over. He walked down to the road for the mail, and we were discussing the comb over with his brother. As he walked up, I looked at him and said, "Dude, I have to say something. You're bald. Your comb over isn't fooling anyone. You should just cut that thing off and be a decent-looking bald guy, because the comb over isn't working." The next time we saw him, it was gone. His long beard was cut shorter, and he was losing weight. It was true. He did look a lot better. Americans should drive cross-country. If you live in a city on the East Coast and haven't traveled by car across the West, you have no idea how beautiful and vast this country is. The East is so congested. Driving across South Dakota from Sioux Falls to Deadwood was the most surreal thing ever to me. And driving through Iowa. Man. I lived in a metro area of Connecticut. Traveling through Iowa, holy cow, I didn't know there could be that much land and corn. In Connecticut, if there's a piece of land, they cut down the trees and build condos or a shopping plaza. Go watch a movie in a theater by yourself. When you have people with you, even if you both are perfectly quiet and never talk to each other once, there is still a sort of unspoken social obligation between you. Going by yourself is strangely liberating and really aids in enjoyment of the film and experience, in my opinion. Edit. For the record, I'm not bashing going with friends. I love doing that too. I think you can get enjoyment out of either experience. It just boils down to what you as a person want from an evening at the movies. Go do a discovery flight and log the time. General aviation pilot here. You probably have 2 to 3 flight schools within 30 miles of your house. They will have something called a discovery flight. You sit left seat where the pilot in command normally sits, and it's usually somewhere around $70 for a 45-minute flight. The instructor will handle the takeoff and landing, and when you get up there, she or he will give you some headings to fly, maybe an altitude or two to hit, and then take you back to the airport. You get an incredible view of your area, you get to fly a plane, and if you buy a pilot logbook, $10 on Amazon or at the flight school, you can have the instructor sign it and have actual time logged while flying a plane, which you can then use towards your license if you ever pursue it. Even if you have zero desire to actually become a pilot, it's an awesome experience. Gift certificates for discovery flights are my go-to for Christmas birthday presents for people that I really like but don't know what to buy. Edit. Wow, this blew up. Thanks for my first, second, and third plat. For those commenting on the price, your mileage may vary when it comes to that, but in general, discovery flights are operated at a loss. For example, at my flight school, C-172 time is $130 wet, fuel included, per hour, and instruction is like $55 per hour. So $185 per hour to fly. But discovery flights are less than half that. Taking a bit of a loss on the discovery allows them to possibly hook a student pilot who may burn $7K-$11K in a 6-month period to become a pilot, so it's usually worth it for them. Some places may be more, but if you're in an area where they're very expensive, there's also likely multiple options and one probably far less than the rest. You likely have some places with a few Cirrus and a Piper, and another place with a Cessna 172 and a 152 or something. I would say to conquer a major fear in your life. I grew up with major social anxiety, and because of that, I was horrible at talking to people, which cycled back into said anxiety. It sucked, to say the least, to feel horribly alone and disconnected, yet bring terrified of putting myself out to anyone but the closest of close friends. Then, I made a decision that changed my life forever. I founded my high school's robotics team. As nerdy as that sounds, it truly made me break my social anxiety, and even made me realize that I was an extrovert. I was pushed by so many supportive mentor figures and friends in my life to break out of my social turtle shell. Because I was one of the founders and the elected president, I was required to talk to parents, teachers, sponsors, and many other people. I ran booths at STEM fairs and talked to huge crowds of people and ended up on the local news several times. This shattered my social anxiety. After that much public speaking and personal interaction, I overcame that fear, and I grew so much because of it. Heck, I realized I was an extrovert. Me. a shut and dorky nerdy loner for 10 years. So I would recommend facing a major source of fear in your life. You don't even need to fully conquer that fear, just do something that your fear would otherwise prevent. Afraid of heights? Try a skywalker skydiving at least once. Afraid of public speech? Try giving a public talk at least once. I'm not saying that every fear can be overcome. It's mentally exhausting to fight fear, and sometimes it's not a war you can win. My case involved 4 years of fighting to overcome that social anxiety, and I still do have some anxiety. Overcoming a fear will not be as easy as doing something once. But if you can win just one battle, then you can celebrate that one victory. Thanks for watching. What did you think of the story time? Let me know in the comments below. If you liked the video, smash that like button and subscribe so you don't miss any more story times.